In this video, I show you another way of how you can prove that a language is not regular by using closure properties. As before, I have this language given, and I could use a pumping lemma on this, but I could also use a simpler way. And I already know that this language is not regular, because, well, the task assumes it, but I have also shown it in another video. So, I will again use the proof by contradiction. I will make the assumption that L2 is regular, which will lead to a contradiction if it's not. So, and that means if L2 is regular, then L2 is closed under homomorphism. That means now I'm defining a homomorphism, and that just means that I can replace any string by any other string. So in this case, I'm defining my homomorphism as a function, and whatever I, when I put in CD, so when in this language, when I have a word from this language and somewhere CD appears, then I want it in my L-bar language, I want it to be an A. If in this language I have, in any words I have an E, I want it to become a B. And I can also say that if I have an F in this function, then I would just want it, I want it to become the empty string in my new language, so I just drop it. And that means if I have now my new language, so in which I have replaced CD by A, that means now I got A to the power of N instead of CD. And then I have E, and I now will, instead of E I want to have B, so I have now B to the power of N, and I will drop the epsilon, so I will drop the F because it becomes epsilon, so I don't need to write it down here. And as before, n is greater or equal than 0. And as you can now see, I have already a contradiction here, because as I said, if L2 is regular, then a homomorphism of L2 must also be regular. But this language is not regular because I know that I have already shown, or I already know that this language is not regular. And therefore, that means, because I got a contradiction, that means this assumption is wrong, and if L2 in that case is not regular.